Ray marching is a rendering technique that differs from the standard pipeline in 3D graphics. It is, however, similar to traditional ray tracing, with the difference being that we iteratively march the ray towards the objects to find the intersection point. This iterative nature of ray marching allows it to handle the rendering of complex, mathematically defined surfaces like fractals or clouds, something that cannot be achieved with ray tracing or the standard rasterization approaches. In this video, we'll go through the basic setup for a simplified ray marching scene in 3.js, and by the end, we'll have something like this. If you are interested in the code itself, you will find the link for a GitHub repository down in the description of this video. The algorithm is pretty straightforward. We have a function, which we'll call scene, that accepts a position in 3D space and returns the closest distance from that position to the objects in our scene. With that, we can create a ray for every pixel in our screen and use this function to see how far we need to march our ray before we hit an object. If the distance to our scene becomes very small, we consider that to be a hit and output color to that pixel using a lighting model like blend fog. Sounds easy enough, so let's now implement it in 3.js. Let's first make a new 3.js project. I use Vite with vanilla.js. And after cleaning up the initialization code that Vite gives, we can start with creating a new 3.js scene. We first import 3.js into our scene. Then create a scene, a camera, a renderer, a directional light, and add a background color and some orbit controls so we can easily navigate through our scene. After that, we can start by creating a plane that will act as our window to the ray marching view. This plane will need to follow along and always be placed on the near plane of our camera. So first, we create our plane with a shader material, and then scale it so that it's the same size as the camera's near plane. Then, we need to define the uniforms, vertex, and fragment shaders of our shader material. We start with the uniforms, which will include the hit epsilon, which is the smallest distance that will indicate for us a hit, maximum distance, which is the maximum distance our array can travel, maximum steps, we add this as a way to break our marching loop if it's consuming a lot of computational resources, clear color, which is the same as our background color. We will use this when we do not hit anything in our scene. Camera uniforms. These are uniforms that we will use to calculate the ray origin and ray direction for each pixel. Light uniforms. These are uniforms that we will use in our lighting model calculations. And time, which we will use to animate our scene. Now for the shaders, which we will define as strings of code, we first have to define a vertex shader, which for our purposes is pretty straightforward. We only need to pass our UV data to our fragment shader, which we will use for the per pixel ray calculation. As a side note though, if you are curious how I'm getting syntax highlighting for GLSL strings, I use the extension GLSL literal that does exactly that. For the fragment shader, we first have to define the inputs we'll get from the vertex shader and the uniforms we'll get from the CPU. Then, we define our scene, which will also use a smooth minimum function as we're blending between two spheres. And now, for the most important function, the actual ray marcher. This function will accept a ray origin and a ray direction and will output the total distance the ray marched. It does that by first marching the ray, which is done by calculating a new position for the ray in space, then by finding what is the closest distance to our scene. If the closest distance is less than our hit epsilon, or we reach the maximum distance, we break the loop and return our total distance. Otherwise, we add our current distance to our total distance. Before we define our main function for the fragment shader though, we still need two functions that we will use for our lighting model. Mainly, a color output for the scene and a function to calculate the normal of our hit point. I won't focus on these functions as they, alongside lighting models, can be their own video, and this video is just focusing on the ray marching function. Finally, our main function. We begin by extracting the UVs from the vertex shader. This will help us know which pixel we are at. Then, we calculate our ray origin and ray direction and find the total distance that we march by calling our ray marching function. If the total distance exceeds the maximum distance, that means we've hit nothing and we can just output our clear color. Otherwise, we calculate the hit position and the normal and use that to calculate our final pixel output using our lighting model. With the shaders and uniforms defined, we can finally attach them to our shader material and add our plane to the scene. The last thing we need to do is define the animation loop, where we'll update the position and rotation of our ray marching plane so that it always follows the camera. We also need to update the uniforms and orbit controls and render our scene. As an added thing, we can also handle window resizing. Lastly, we need to define the margins of our body tag in our HTML to be 0, since otherwise we will get a border around our scene. With all this defined, we can run yarn and yarn dev and see our scene inside our browser. If you're interested in the code, you will find a link to a GitHub repository and another link to a code pen for this project down in the description of this video. In the next video, we'll discuss how to optimize our renderer with cone marching. This would let us render more complex SDFs like fractals. But if you're interested in seeing the optimization right now, you can find links to two articles I wrote about this, which this video and the one after will follow closely, down in the description as well. Lastly, if you're interested in supporting me and getting a nice game at the same time, you can just purchase Fractal Glide on Steam. It's a game I made where the rendering is completely handled by ray and cone marching. That's it for now. Until next time, bye-bye.